Welcome back to the third installment of this incredible series of John Galan showing us all of the incredible ways to leverage the Privy software. Now, in this final installment, what John is going to do is show us how he can vet properties. He calls it soft vetting. Now, what does that mean? Soft vetting is how do you look at a property and determine whether or not this property is worth spending additional time on. In real estate investing, we get a lot of opportunities, and when we're prospecting, we're looking through a lot of different homes. Now, you can spend hours upon hours upon hours a day looking at stuff that's not going to pencil out and not make you any money. So what are the fast ways to identify if there could be a potential opportunity or soft vetting a property so that you know if you should spend more time and focus in deeper? So what we're going to do is we're going to put our attention on John. But before we do that, again, I'm going to remind you that more than 60% of you guys who watch my channel aren't subscribed. I don't know how you guys find these things, and I don't know how you guys end up here, but you do, and you're getting value because you showed up again. So do both of us a favor and hit the subscribe button. And without further ado, take it away, John.
Hey, everybody. If you watched my last two videos, you know who I am. If you didn't, well, I'm John Galan, and I definitely recommend you go back and watch my last two Privy videos. Right now, I will be discussing how to keep track of the properties you went through so you can just mass import them into your CRM if your CRM allows you to import a CSV file. Right now, I'm just going to go ahead. I run my list. Obviously, if you watched the last two, you know that these are properties that I have to go through that I might want to call an agent on. So once I run them, now is when I will go through the properties. I will quickly look through them and see, like, does this look like I want to call on? Yeah, it looks like it could use some work. First thing I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to go to comparables, and I'll click all activity, and I'll see. Okay, so this thing's been on for 37 days on market. If everything around here is in the mid to low twos, and this thing's at 294, I can tell you right now, I'm going to be either significantly below list price or just not anywhere close to even offer on the property. So I won't want to call on this. That's why I soft vet. So soft vetting is not comping a property. It's just making sure the property is worth my time to call an agent on. This is pretty, I want to say clean, but I mean, like, it's got dirty walls and that's about it. So I'm assuming, based on looking at this photo, I'm assuming it's going to be listed kind of where everything is. So how I soft vet is I'll just look around here. And I'll see. 37 days on market, I could probably get away with being close to $80,000 off the list. So right from the bat, I'll just do 294 minus 80,000. And in Pinellas Park, which is in Pinellas County, I know I could lock properties up at 60%. So if I don't see properties that sold around the 350 range, I know I'm not going to be too close to 350 or above. I know I'm not going to be 80K or below list price. So I'll quickly just look for the year build, you know, just staying here. Okay, I have a 370, 200, 165, 290. And I'm just looking at the price, the square footage. Like right here, show me a 370. This one looks not too bad. So let's just say, just to keep it simple, that 370 right now could potentially be my ARV. I'm just looking again, anything else, 15, 102, 265, 400. Okay, here's one. It's 1308. It's a little bit bigger. 375. When did this one sell? This one sold back in June. So I'll quickly just do 370 times 0.9. I'm taking 10% off for selling back over 90 days ago. And then times 0.6, I'm around 199 potentially, minus 294. Means I'm around $94,000 off list. I will be. Without even running numbers, I know that. It's only been 37 days on market. To be honest with you, I'm not going to call this one because I don't think it's worth it. So what I'll do is I'll just click manage list. And I'll put did not pass soft vet. So again, I didn't comp that. I don't know if the ARV is 370. I'm just not wasting my time calling the agent, finding out the information about the property, then comping it and finding out my ARV is around where I just said it was, and knowing I'm going to probably be around 100K off of list price for like 37 days. If I was between the 80,000, then I would have added it and it might have been worth a shot. So let's go down. You could either use this view or you could use this view. It's up to you. So let's just say I go through this one. Horrible pictures. It's like spotty pictures. You can see this one does need some work. So let's go to comparables again. I'll just make sure all activity, and it's been on for 28 days on market. So let's just say I could probably get away with being around, let's just do 60, even 60 might be right. Divided by In Spring Hill, I'll probably want to be around 55%. So I need to see stuff selling for 250 or above. So I'll quickly look again. Scroll down. I'll sort by my year build just so I know I'm not looking at anything too new. And I'm a 1,200 square foot home, right? Okay, 199. Everything's in the ones right now. I don't see anything in 250. I'm at 69. Okay, still nothing in 250. This one, I'll probably pass on. Because let's just say ARV is closer. Let's like even take the 305 that's sold in June. Times 0.9, 274. Hey, actually, I'm close. I'm wrong. See, that's why I do estimate an ARV real quick. So I will call this one. It is 28 days of market, and I could potentially be $50 off. I know in Spring Hill, a lot of properties are around like the 250, 260 range anyway. So it's worth a shot, right? And they might have something else. So what I'm going to do now, I'm not going to go ahead and just go quickly add them to my CRM because I want to go through all of these properties at once.
Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe. And here's a quick word from our sponsor.
Hey there. This video is brought to you by Privy. Do yourself a favor and click on the link in the description. Privy can help you find real estate deals at a deep discount. Don't be a jabroni. Click on the linky.
So I have a sheet. So other counties, Hillsborough, Pinellas. These headings, these are specific for my CRM because I know where I need to tag certain things in order to add them to my CRM. But I'm not going to go down and show you how to do get all the agent information and all that stuff because that's not about Privy. Even though Privy does have the email sometimes. But all I'm doing is I'm going to copy the address, put it here, copy town, city, paste it here. And then I'm just going to copy the agent's information, which is just this. Place it here. So now I know it's on my Excel, so I'm going to have to get their information. I will add them. So I'm going to take them off of this list and just put them to added CRM looked at before. Save. And then I work my way down. For instance, this one. This one looks pretty clean. Looks like it could potentially be a flip, right? So since I could tell, you could tell a flip, it's easy, right? But let me see, was this, yep. So this was bought in 2022 and it's an LLC. So I'm going to, Port Richey's in Pasco County. So it's not going to go into my market research to do. It's going to go into my other markets market research and then save. I'm not going to call an agent on a flip, but I do want to see who that buyer is in case I get anything in Port Richey. And then you just work your way down. Here's another one. I mean, you guys tell me, does this look like a house that could be wholesalable? I think so. Same thing. Go to comparables, hit all activity. I'm in St. Petersburg. It's been 48 days on markets. I could be a little aggressive and say I could get away with 90K off, right? Let's just do that. Divided by 0.6. I need to see things, but I need to see ARV above list price. And again, you'll know based on your market, it's always going to be different, but I'm dividing by my cosmetic ARV percentage. So if I was going to lock up a property in St. Petersburg, cosmetic, I could lock it up at 60% of ARV and still be able to dispo it. That's my MAO. So I'm just kind of getting a range, like where do I need to see a range of sales? And then I do the same thing. Build, okay, these are all the older ones, but I need to be around, I think it was like, yeah, around like 240. So I'm looking 11142. So like, look, there's a lot of different sales that are around the 340 range. I'll probably give this one a call. Manage lists. It's in here still. So I didn't add it yet. So now I know I have to add it. So I will copy this and do the same thing. I'll add it to my Excel sheet. And then once I do, I will put it as added to CRM, looked at before, and then save. And then, like I said, every now and then, once you're done, you can just refresh the list by clicking list and clicking this little icon right here. At the end of the day or at the end of the week, you want this to be zero and you want this to be zero. That means you've looked at all of your properties. You've soft vetted the properties. You've added the ones you wanted to the CRM and you are good to continue calling. And then you'll get a new email on the weekend. You'll do the same thing on the weekend or you'll do it on Monday. And then you could continue just adding properties. And you know that you're up to date because the properties that get sent to your email, you don't have to run the list again because you already ran it as of a certain day. So everything new from that day on is in your email. So you just got to worry about those emails and you keep track of it in the lists. And you could always just go back to a list and check on the property again. So that's my Privy process. It's been helping me a lot to stay organized. So I know if I miss a property or if I can't solve vet on a certain day or go through them, I at least just quickly go through the email and add them to a certain list so that's in the funnel for me to look at so I don't lose my properties. I keep track of which ones I've seen already because once you look at hundreds or even thousands of properties, you're going to forget, have I seen this before? Oh, click manage lists. Oh, I have seen this before or I haven't seen this before. And then you could go ahead and add them how you're supposed to. So once more, thank you again for watching. Thank you again to Jamil for having me on here to show you how I utilize Privy. If you liked any of these videos, please like and subscribe. And if you know that somebody could use this and could get a lot of help and value from this, please share it with them. And if you don't have Privy, I highly recommend you get it because it is a game changer. I will not say that if I don't believe in it, and I 100% believe in it. I mean, hey, it's got me 11 deals within, 5 months, so it could get anybody else the same.
Thanks for watching another one of my YouTube videos. Now it's your turn to go out and take some action. But before you do, like and subscribe to my channel because the law of reciprocity means you owe me.